So far, we've assumed that polynomials are represented by their coefficients. For example, a is equal to negative x plus 1 times x plus 1 times x squared, for example. If you've ever worked with polynomial interpolation or fitting before, however, you will know that an order n polynomial is uniquely characterized by its values at any n distinct point. The order of a polynomial, by the way, is the number of coefficients used to define it, or the degree plus 1. Hence, we might just as well represent a polynomial by its values at a sequence of inputs as by its coefficients. For example, that same polynomial could be represented by saying that a of negative 1 is negative 2, a of 0 is negative 2, and a of 1 is 0. Going from the coefficient representation to the value representation can be thought of as matrix multiplication. To calculate a at some value, I take the dot product of the corresponding row of the matrix consisting of the powers of the argument x with this column consisting of the coefficients of the polynomial a. This matrix is important enough that it gets its own name and is called a Vandermonde matrix. Its determinant is the product of the differences of all the values of x. So, as long as these are distinct, the determinant will be non-zero, and that means the matrix is invertible. So, given the values, then, we should be able to recover the coefficients.